I'm Alex Conroy, and today we'll be doing a motion problem. Our question is, a ball is vertically thrown upwards with an initial velocity of 20 meters per second. How long is the ball in the air? So first thing I like to do is draw a diagram. Our ball is going to start here and go upwards. We know its initial velocity is 20 meters per second. We're going to list our five things and fill in what we know. Next, we're going to cut this in half. So here is our halfway point. We know that our final velocity here is going to be zero. And free fall, the acceleration is negative 9.8. Now, we have to solve for time and displacement. First, we're going to solve for time. We're going to use our acceleration formula. Acceleration equals final velocity minus initial velocity divided by time. We know we could get time by itself by multiplying on each side, leaving us with this equation. If we divide acceleration, we're left with time. Now, we plug in what we know. T equals our final velocity, zero, minus our initial, 20, over acceleration, negative 9.8. We use unit analysis to make sure we get the correct labels. Our S, one of the S's cancel out, and both of our meters. So we're left with our final answer is 2.04 seconds. We could fill in here. Next, we find displacement using our displacement formula. Displacement equals initial velocity times time plus half acceleration times time squared. We have all of our information, so let's plug it in. X equals the initial velocity, 20, times our time, which is 2.04, plus half the acceleration times time squared. We're going to plug this into unit analysis. Yes. Okay, now you can simplify and multiply to get our final answer. Our S is canceled, leaving us with the meters, plus 20.39, and our S cancel. We're left with meters again, and now we could solve for this. So 40.8 minus from our negative acceleration, 20.39 equals 20.41 meters. So that means that this time right here, our halfway, is 20.41 meters. Okay, so that solves our first question. How high is the highest, this solves our question B. What is the greatest height reached by the ball? It's 20.41, right here. Okay, going back to question A, how long is the ball in the air? We have to find now the total amount. So if we know that this is halfway, this is also the other half. So we times 20.41 times 2. So when we make our chart for the second half, which is right here, we know that our initial velocity, starting right here, is going to be 0. Our final velocity is unknown. Our acceleration is double this, leaving us with 40.82 meters. And our time is, again, double. So if it took 2.04 seconds to get to the halfway point, it's going to take 2.4 seconds to get to the other half. So 2.04 times 2 equals 4.08 seconds. And our acceleration for free fall is negative 9.8. That remains the same. Now we have to find our final velocity. So that answers question one, how long is the ball in the air? So this equals the total time. So we could fill in some of these answers over here. So A is 4.08 seconds. B is what is the greatest height? Right here is our greatest height, is 20.41 meters. And now we have to answer question C, where is the ball at 3 seconds? Coming over here, we're going to make another little diagram. We know our acceleration for free fall always remains constant at 9.8 meters per second squared. Our time, it's asking where the ball is at 3 seconds, so we fill in 3 seconds. We don't know our displacement, so that's what we're trying to figure out. And our initial velocity is 20 meters per second. And our final velocity is unknown. So first, we need to find our final velocity. Actually, we don't need final velocity to find displacement. So we're going to use our displacement formula, x equals the initial velocity only, times time plus half, acceleration times time squared. Using this equation, we can plug it in. X equals 20 times time, which is 3, plus 1 half the acceleration, negative 9.8, times time, 3 squared. So we're going to plug this into our unit analysis. X equals 20 meters over seconds. Times 3 seconds plus half, negative 9.8 meters per second squared. We're running out of room, and 3 seconds squared. So here still here. We could solve this. This equals 60. Our label is seconds cancel out meters. Plus, we're going to do the top, then the bottom. So, negative 9.8 times 3 times 3, because it's squared, is 88.2 negative over divided by 2. -44.1. Our seconds cancel, we're left with meters. 44.1 meters equals, so we have to subtract those, 60 minus 44.1, 15.9. So at 3 seconds, the ball was at 15.9 meters. So there we have it. We just solved a motion problem with a diagram and using dimensional analysis. Hand it over. Using dimensional analysis, using a diagram, and I hope this was helpful.